Hi everyone, my name is Ivan and welcome to Ivan Rashkov Tennis. In today's video, I want to talk about the one problem that could really happen when you teach or learn about the J-toss. First of all, I want to start with this video addressing all the coaches, and I would advise try not to create so many different concepts about the technique when you teach your kids or when you teach students about learning about tennis. Concepts might be good, but at the same time might be very bad, because you don't coach your kids or students to become coaches. You might, but basically you teach your students, I'm talking about younger kids, you teach them how to become competitors. And creating all of these concepts, basically you're preparing them to become tennis coaches. So find a way to trick your students. You don't have to tell them everything, but you can teach them everything on a subconscious level. And I'm sure that if you've been teaching tennis for many years, you know what I'm talking about. If you haven't, then you still have to learn some things about teaching about the sport of tennis and how you could really get to the students in the most efficient way. Second of all, I want to address to the kids who might be watching this video, and please listen to my advice. Don't get stuck in learning about technique so much. You really need to go out there and learn how you can compete. You really need to learn how you can win. And the technique is very helpful, but at the same time can be very burdening. And I really talk from my own experience on that level. So don't waste too much time on YouTube or different internet contents that really you're learning from, because you really gotta let go of these concepts and you really have to go and just do your best on the court with what you know. And if you have a good coach, they will help you with your technique. If you don't have a good coach, yes, you gotta go out there and find something on the internet that you trust and learn from it, but you have to let go of that at the end and focus and transition your mind from thinking too much about the technique and different concepts, because they won't help you at the end, to transfer your mind to really competing and focusing about how you could win against your opponent. I hope in this channel I could really give you some more advice in the future how to do that. So maybe if you stick around, you could learn something about it. And finally, I want to talk about today's topic in the video, the J-toss. So when we talk about this, tossing the ball forward, or what coaches have we've been telling about the J-toss, and this is where the toss goes forward when you're tossing. The simple idea of this concept or whatever is being explained, that your toss goes forward every time. So in a different video, I'm going to talk about the toss itself. In today's video, I want to talk about what happens when you might be learning about this kind of toss, or if you're teaching about this kind of toss. So be careful with that. And the main problem that could happen is that when you're doing the toss, at the end, you might have your arm goes forward, and in that way you might lose one of the most important things in the technique of the serve, which is to pull back your arm and really feel that stretch back and this extension, which really helps you with the pop later on the serve. And people who've played a lot of tennis, they will know that you might have a great technique, but this one little thing here, if you don't do it at the end, where you pull back your arm and you really stretch that part, you really won't produce the most efficient pop on your serve. So here I want to show you the problems that I'm talking about, and don't get confused with going with the left arm forward when you've pulled back before that. Of course, you gotta let it drop down, because this is going to create more acceleration with the body, which will give you a stronger serve, more powerful serve. I'm talking about when you're learning about or teaching about this type of toss, how your arms ends up moving forward right after you have tossed. And I'll show you how it looks like. So you're getting ready, you're tossing from the inside, and you could see the arm goes down earlier, which helps the ball to go lower. But when you're a kid, you might have a lot of problems with that because you're going to keep hitting downwards towards the net. Also, you won't be able to produce that strength and the power in the serve that I'm trying to explain. You won't produce that pop. So here we go, the second serve where I'm trying to explain, you pull the arm back first and then you can let it go down after you have topped. Thank you guys again for your time. And you, if you want to learn more about tennis, if you really want to learn more about the way I teach tennis, you could go to my website that I will add in the description down below, and you could check out my complete and thorough course that can take you step by step how you could teach or learn tennis. And it's a great aid for all of the coaches that are starting or the coaches who want to learn more about the technique in tennis, or a great aid for the parents who really want to support their kids on this journey of tennis. So go check it out, and thank you again. My name is Ivan, and this is Ivan Rashkov Tennis. I will see you in my next video.